Assassin's Creed Origins is supposed to have a huge post-launch DLC, so let's unpack everything we know so far, including stuff I learned from my interview with the game director and some new stuff we just learned. So let me know what you think in the comments down below, and a like would be super appreciated. At E3 2017, I asked Azeroth Ismail, the game director on Assassin's Creed Origins, about the life after launch for Assassin's Creed Origins, since a ton of the Ubisoft games are moving into the live service game direction with a ton of support after launch. While Assassin's Creed Origins will be a single player focused game, it will have online features. What they do was not announced yet, only that they will enhance the single player experience. As for the content, Ismail said that it will be amazing unique stuff and that they will talk about it later on in the marketing campaign of the game. Now we learned, because of the newly released photo of the Dawn of the Creed edition, that we will get the season pass info closer to launch. So that means that they will talk about it before the game comes out. The content of the season pass was already confirmed earlier. We will be looking at two major expansions and customization packs for Assassin's Creed. So probably two new areas with new stories, new enemies, weapons, missions, quests. Just the stuff that you come to expect from an RPG expansion. So yeah, now we know that we will learn more about these expansions, or at least one expansion, before the game comes out. Also not weird, otherwise you will sell an expansion without telling people what they will get from that. Not really smart. The season pass will cost $40 or $30 if you decide to buy the Assassin's Creed Origins Gold Edition, that also comes with the Deluxe Edition pack that is worth $10. This comes with a special outfit, mount, weapons, a special mission, and 3 ability points. Why the ability points? Really, I don't know, probably to give you a head start or something. To be fair, it will not matter at all. Like, you will get ability points from doing a lot of stuff, and also at the max level, you will of course keep getting these ability points to spend in your monster nodes. Want to know more about that? Of course, check out my Endless Endgame video by clicking on the screen. Anyway, the $40 price tag suggests that we will indeed be looking at huge expansions, probably around the $20 each. Comparable with The Witcher's Blood and Wine expansion, for example. So if that 30-hour expansion is anything to go off of, I think the content will be enormous. Ismail noted in an interview I had with him at Gamescom that they will support the game for quite a long time, of course talking about the expansions, but he also said feature sets and enhancing the experience. So while the huge content updates will be paid, I would not be surprised if there were also free updates to keep you coming back to the game. When we can expect these expansions, it's hard to say right now, but I think early 2018 for the first one, with the second one in the summer. It also depends on the fact if Ubisoft wants to release another Assassin's Creed game next year. Then of course you want to release the expansions for Origins before the new one comes out, probably in October 2018. I think it would be smarter to support AC Origins for a year and a half and then release a new Assassin's Creed game in October 2019, but of course nothing is certain yet. It's just my speculation. When we know more about the DLC, so yeah, before release, I will let you know, so be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on more Assassin's Creed Origins content. I also have a ton of content about the game already up, like the video where I showcased all the weapon types and their super attacks, so check that out by clicking on the screen. Like the video to support the channel, thanks a lot for watching, and I will speak to you next time. Goodbye.